Hello everyone, Thranxes here, and welcome back to Conan Exiles episode 31, where bugs are fixed. So just to show you, our water skin, full of water, building placement is back in action, so we're going to finally get to build. Now I've done a little bit of maintenance with a few of my things here, gathered a few extra things, a little bit extra stone, make some more foundations. And looks like I've used all that stone, made more. Okay, and I dropped off. So I dropped off a lot of my tools. I repaired some of them, and I got rid of pretty much everything out of my inventory so that I could carry as much as possible for when we start building. Let's see. So what I want to do is get some stairs and maybe a few more foundations? No, I don't. 30 is good. Alright, let's try that. So here's my thought. So I came up here and I placed a little bit more foundations down and around where it slopes. So my thought process is to elevate this. So let's get a view here. If I do this, that means the stairs would go here. So then the stairs would look like this, which would leave me two squares? That's reasonable. I don't want... Okay. Alright, let's start putting the foundation where I know I'm going to need it at least. So we'll start putting the foundation here. Ooh, are you going to let me do this? Into the sand? Look at that. Okay. Oh, and looks like I left... Looks like I'd thrown one here. By accident, I guess. I don't know. Anyways, that works out. So it attaches to that. So then if I do the stairs there, no, that's way too many. So we're going to do another row of foundations, actually, right here. Failed to place. Try again. There you go. Don't get finicky with me. Failed to place. There you go. So it didn't want to go there without something on either side. All right. So look at that. That's pretty good. So now if I place the stairs here... Okay, let's maybe center it up. Well, we got one. Or maybe I don't want to center it up. Okay, so I'm going to need a second wheel of pain, which I'm going to put here. I think that's good. That's plenty of room. So then I'll come around here and we'll go, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, so then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let me see, it's an even number. So we're going to need what? Do 3 on either side? 1, nope, 1. How about that? No, failed to place. Failed to place. Failed to place. Why would that be? Okay, that one is good. Failed to place that one. Failed to place that one. That one. Okay, ugh. Arrgh! Stairs on either side, so at least... Okay, that's progress. I don't think I could put that one earlier. Oh, look at that. It's figured it out. It's fixed itself. Done as if by order. Okay, so then we'll dismantle there. There's going to be a little bit of waste. That's fine. Okay, so what do we got? We've got these stairs here. We can maybe put a little something over here. I'm likely going to use wedge foundations there. Yes, I believe so. Let's go do that. And then we'll need to get some walls, perhaps? I don't know. Am I going to be able to... So from here... All right, let's just analyze what our foundations do up here. All right, so that's our wall. That's as far back as we're going to be able to go. Our wall is going to go like that. So the house itself, perhaps that row should be wedges, and then I can kind of slope the wall in there instead of having this rough corner where the building could be more on this side. Ooh. Yeah. Okay. All right. I'm starting to get the vision here. Let's go like that and like that. And then I might even just do stairs the whole way. Oh. No, I don't. We'll leave them for now. We'll leave them for now. So then the building is actually going to face this direction. Right? Yeah. All right. Let's see if I can get another. I can. How many? Ooh, that's quite a... Okay. That's good. So that means the wall... If I run the wall here, though, we're going to get a little bit of stone. All right, let's go get some walls and see what it looks like. Because then we'll be able to stair-step up to the other one. We have more foundations. No. Let's see. Walls, windows. Oof. Too many. Okay. Fair enough. Fair enough. We'll just take half. Just half. That's fine. That's fine for now. And then we're going to need one door frame. And one door. One door, please. Just one. One will do. Alright, let's take a look at what this is going to look like. And I'll do that edge. So I'll probably run wedges here. And then put fences just to make... Or maybe I could run it straight into the stone. I don't know. I like the fact that the stone and the sand is like running right into the structure. I really like the way that looks. This is supposed to be, you know, a mountain fortress. Alright, let's look at walls here. So if I try to put a wall there, that wall will be inside of the building. Let's just see how this looks. Right, so... I don't know about that. We're gonna roll with it for now. Okay, windows. We're gonna go over here. And I'm just gonna have a whole row of windows. Or maybe every other one? Where do the stairs start? Okay, alright. This is a process. I think we're gonna go like this. And then... Oh, maybe that should be... Yeah. Yeah, okay. Alright, alright. I don't want to waste too much, but at that same time, I want it to look good. So, here's what we're going to do. We're going to throw these back for now. And instead, I'm going to take some sandstone wedge formation foundation pieces. We'll put the door back for now. And then we'll take half the walls again, and then we'll take half the windows again. Oh no, it's too many. Ah! Alright, we'll put back... Not enough space in inventory. You must be out of your mind. Take 26 of them, please. There you go, 97%. That works. Now, grab these onto my bar, please. Okay. So my thought process is... to do... like a wedge... If I do the wedge formation here... then I kind of get the slope that I'm looking for. Failed to place building. Really? Really? I mean, I know that... Okay, let's try to dismantle you, and then place you, and then you. Look at that. And then piece over there, piece over there. That's plenty good. I'm not even going to worry about that. I just want it to look... Oh, hello. Hold on. Yeah. Or do I want that one to be square? That one I might want to be square, actually. Because then I can round that one out with the wall. Okay. So then over here... let's get a view of the building. We'll start where it's four wide. So then these... right here are going to be wedges. So we're getting a little bit of our stone and wood back. Not all of it, unfortunately, but that's okay. We can just use it to make more of what we need. Which, at this point, let's go ahead and just craft three square foundations. That's fine. So now, let me see. Put it like this. There we go. Oh, wait, no, I should have started over here because the goal is to have it angled like that. Right. Oh, and it works! Wonderful. And then this one can be... Oh, that's going to be tricky. No, I could probably put square foundations there later. Alright, so then my thought process is exactly the wall will kind of round up against the stone like that. And then continue. Alright, so let's start putting our walls down. Right, and then at an angle. And then like that. Okay. Nice. So that gives it kind of a neat look inside. I want my buildings to be have a little bit of character. I don't want them to be incredibly round. That's going to be an issue. How to overcome that? Well, the possibility is that we will just stair step up without putting a wall on that face. That's an interesting thought. Okay, let's throw out a window here. And then do we want a window every single space or maybe every other space? The door should be there. So then I guess I could do a window here, but there's really not much of a view or a point to do that. We could put the... No. I want the outer face to go... No. Like that. And then... Here. Alright, so then if I went every other one, then I would need one here. So I'm at least going every other one. I feel confident with that. Ooh, we need a drink. Thirsty. And our sealed water skin works for us, so we don't have to worry about having to run down to the river every single time. So that's good. I also made a ton more gruel, and I got even more cooking on the fire, so that we're just going to let our thrall just sit here as long as it takes, and I am just going to keep this Wheel of Pain so full of gruel that we're not going to have an issue. Now, back to here. What I'm thinking... Do I want to do a wedge formation there? I might, because then I can slope the wall in. Oh, see, I almost wish I could slope the wall on this side, but then this whole row here would have to be wedge foundations. Do I want that square edge on the front of my... Let me look at it from this side. I don't think I'm going to. Oh, this is gonna get messy. Oh, this is gonna get messy. Well, I think at this point, So I don't know how much of this you guys want to actually witness or how much you want to edit out. I hate to waste pieces in front of everybody, but honestly, in hindsight, I probably could have done this entire row in wedges. So let me see. So then this would be an angle, an angled piece. Then the door frame would have to go here. No, let's keep it square for now. That's not too bad. Because we're gonna have rounder shaped buildings on other sides, but some of this can be squared off. I don't want it all to be round. All right, so we'll stick with what we have. And then I think what we'll do is, all right, let's put down, this might be a waste, but I need to see it to believe it. So we've got windows, every other square. No, there's a beautiful view out there. I think this is where we're gonna go window every square here. That's what I think. All right. Let's take a look. Yeah, I rather like that. I think that's good. Alright, so we can take these foundations we made and we can go right here. Okay, we don't even need one there. And then this wall here will not be a window. and then we're going to start putting walls up top. That's what we're going to do. All right, let's get our door and our door frame. Oh, this is so exciting. I've been wanting to do this for so long. All right, we'll need... Let's see. Just one, really. Just one of each for now. And then we're going to need some ceilings. Right, we can take about 20 for now. And we're going to need a couple stairs, at least two. What? What? Whoa! What the heck was that? It's a ghost antelope. Get out of here! You better run. I don't want you here. I don't feel like going to get my sword to deal with that. Alright, so... Doorframe. Stay focused, Thranxes. Okay. 5. Outer face, 6. Door. Alright. So now what I'm thinking is... what am I thinking? I'm thinking... Too high is the way to go. Yeah, it pretty much has to be. So then the only question is, do I do windows above the windows? Alright, let's see what that looks like. I think we should, for now. If we end up tearing them down, then we end up tearing them down. That's just the way it goes. Oh no, what have I done with my wall? Don't wall me in, please. Don't wall me in. Outer face. Oh, that looks good. I like what I'm seeing here. Okay, so the stairs that I grabbed, this is to map out how we're going to transition. So this would go up there. I feel like we would end up needing foundation. Now, do I want these stairs maybe to be more up against the wall here? No, that clobbers the windows. Oh, maybe the stairs would be up over on this side. Oh, we got wedges. The stairs are going to be at an angle there. Oh, tricky. So the stairs are going to need to go in the center, right? And we don't have a way to wall that. That's going to be really tricky here. No, and you're not going to lock onto that. It's like, no, there's terrain there. I'm not locking onto that at all. Oh, wait. Yes! Like that! Oh, they let me do it! So then the question is, could the stairs lock onto that wall, or will the wedges prevent it? And it looks like they're going to prevent it. So we can do the stairs here. Yeah, I think that's a good location. Right there. Okay. And then this is where the next floor will be. Ooh! Okay, we're going to need two stairs, obviously. That is a thing. Come on. Just like I thought, two stairs. I thought about doing a two-wide stairwell, but that takes up a lot of your room. I think here, one stairwell is fine. If I can get it to snap to something. Okay, maybe if I go over here. Whoa, easy does it. Oh no, don't get stuck! Ah! Wow. Really finicky. Oh, wait. No. You were there. Is that? That is. The terrain interferes with the stairs' natural process. So then the question is, do we snap a foundation there, or... do the stairs need to come back one? So I wanted them to be right up against the stone. I think that's going to be too steep, though. All right, well, what we can do is we can start doing our ceiling. Oh, we're going to need wedge ceilings here. That is going to make that section so interesting. Okay. All right, we'll figure that out. We'll work with that. For now, let's start getting a roof over our head And I guess this roof placement is where the foundation needs to be. Why are you not letting me up there? It's almost like I'm not allowed to be up here. Can I snap a foundation to that? Yes. Yes. Okay, so now I need the stairs to connect to that, and that one's gonna have to be a foundation? Question mark? Mm-hmm. Okay, alright, so a little bit of experimentation is gonna be needed. A little bit. But in the meantime, we can still continue with the ceiling. We know we're at least going that way. Failed to place. Alright, how about there? Thank you. And then the next one is wedges. Got it. And then no ceiling there. That's, we don't want a ceiling there. We need more walls. Alright. Let's... Ooh! Immune to this tier of weapon. My door is immune to my fists. I might have some strength, but I don't have that much strength. Alright. Okay, let's take about 15 of these. Ought to be good. These sandstone triangles. We'll hold on to our ceilings. We're going to need a few more walls, so we'll take about 10 of those. And let me see, we have some sandstone wedges. We're going to need some square foundations and some more stairs. So I'm thinking 4 stairs just to play around with them in case we need to break any and put them back down. Now at this point, I want a torch to go right. And also, why am I going to have stairs up to the side of the building here? This is a waste. We're going to dismantle these. Because I can put like a crafting station or maybe another, I'll put another wheel of pain over here. Yeah. Yeah, that's what I'm going to do. I'll put another wheel of pain over there. So we'll have a torch here, and then we'll have a torch here by the door, right here by the... There, that looks good. Okay, let's go get our fence, because that one side is going to bother me until I fence it off, and I want to fence it off. Let's take... Oh, goodness, no. Not that many. 33? I just need 5. Oh, that's still too many! I probably can put... because I've got 100 stone on me. Okay, well, let's make 2 more square foundations. I seem to be going through those the most. Now, another thing to consider, and I've read this online a good bit, even though the devs are working on it, the developers are working on it very hard, is that triangle foundations do not stack currently. Although, to be fair, that could be old information. I'm not 100%. I almost want this one to be a window. You know what? Let's see what that looks like. With the torch in front of it? I might like that. I'm gonna leave it like that for the time being. And that almost makes me think I should put a window there too, just so that it's... no, jury's out on that one. Let's wait. Let's hold off. Okay, outer face. Yep. Very good. And there. So now what I want to do is destroy these stairs and destroy this foundation, right? So that we can figure out where that is going to go and how that's going to work. All right. But until, or before we do that, let's go ahead and throw these triangle roof sections in here. We know we want these. I want this area roofed off. There, like that. Oh, it's looking nifty. It's looking nifty. So we can put something kind of neat in this corner. This corner is a little sharp, which I'm going to live with. I don't want it to be symmetrical necessarily, because we're building up alongside a mountainside, you know, with this cliff face that we have to deal with. So then the question becomes, How to integrate stairs into this section is really what that equals. Now, what if I do this here? Like, oh no, no, no! That's at an angle. That's an angled wall. I can't. Okay, all right. Oh, not my wall. Not anything but my wall. Take my eyes, not my wall. All right. So, if we connect this wall here like that, I almost feel like the foundation needs to go there, and then I don't think we want the foundation coming out like that. It's almost impossible for me to get up there, though, with these stairs. So what if we start the stairs further back? Like this, and then... No, 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 no. Snap to... Okay. Snap to there. Wait. Why would you do that to me? Just go up the stairs. Go up the... Oh. That will do it. That'll do it every time. Hey. Now we're talking. This is victory. All right. And we're pretty far up against this cliff wall, which is what I like. But we can continue this building on this rock here. And, see, because now I'm thinking if we use wedge foundations here, we can sort of follow this rounded slope on that end, which I'm like, if I was to do it like this, and then we go over, it would be kind of, I could build it sort of like a triangle edge, but I would want the end to be flat, not pointed. That would look pretty interesting. And we want to follow the curve of this. So I'm trying to think this through a little bit more so I'm not breaking all of my items. Now, if this is a ceiling here, it stands to reason that this should be foundation all the way across, except there's no way to make that foundation without building it foundation from the bottom. And therein lies the question, do I want... All right, ease up. Don't fight with me now. Ugh, it's fighting with me. Maybe it'll let me crouch. It does, it lets me crouch. Ooh, it's dark in here. We're gonna need to learn candles or wall torches or something. I don't think I have any leftover points. I do not. But we can make candles with 1 point. Or bracketed torch with 1 point. Okay, so we'll probably spend a point next level doing that. Actually, that'll be the plan. So next level, which we'll go out and grind here in a little bit. I may even do it off camera. I don't know. We can learn the torch, the candle. No, because we're only going to get 5 points. So we'll learn the gauntlets, the boots, and then the candle. I don't know why, but I like the idea of a candle over a bracketed torch. Yeah. I don't know. I think we'll eventually get both. Oh, goodness. See, now I'm like, maybe I need to have torches in front of all the windows for now. I guess I could put a standing torch in here. No. Let's focus. Focus. The question at hand is, should I put a foundation there? Should I leave the underside of the stairs hollow? Alright, I don't want to mess with that now because it's dark. Instead, I'm going to come over here and do this part. Outer face. Good. And then I think I'm going to build a second wheel of pain while it's dark because I know what I want to do out here. We'll save the inside until it gets light again. Alright, let's put all this stuff back for now. Plus, it'll give me time to digest where the building's heading and what it's doing. Oh, my goodness. It's because I had the fences, right? Yeah, it is. That's an interesting bug, but I kind of understand it. All right. So, My other thought is to do the altar of Mitra out here. Because I am going to eventually, I'm going to run this foundation out. I don't know what I'm going to do about this odd gap that foundations don't want to fit in. I'm not sure about that. That's going to be... That's a little weird. I mean, it looks cool, but... Yeah, I don't know. That's going to get squirrely because these foundations, they don't line up at all. Not even close. They don't want to join even a little bit. But I would like to put the altar of Mitra kind of out here, like overlooking this cliff, and have more, and then this area will also be paved out with foundations, which will take a lot of foundations, but I have a lot of stone and I can get more easily enough. I have a ton of iron. Speaking of, yeah, probably about due to start saving our coal. Now I know we need 100 iron bars for the Wheel of Pain. And do we need any leather? 38 twine, 200, and 200. No, that's easy enough. So we'll go like that, and then that, and then the twine. That should do it. How do we not have 220? I'm 5 wood short. Really? Okay. All right. Now 5 wood makes all the difference. Don't think it doesn't. Ooh, we do have these... Stygian braziers. Maybe I'll use those inside. Oh, yeah. That could be a cool light source. We might make a couple of those. I mean, we already know how, and we have tons of bone. Actually, yeah. That could be really interesting. Let's grab about 40 bone. And then we'll grab 100 stone and some branches. But I really just need, like, 2 branches, I think is what it said. And then how many can we craft? We can craft 2. That'll be cool. Let's see what those look like. All right. Now, for our second Wheel of Pain, we're going to put this right over here. Pretty close to the other one. But I want it as far away from the little entrance here as possible. And I don't want it to... Alright, alright. Let me get some perspective in where it is in relation to the stairs. So we can get it pretty close. Or we can split the difference. See, now if I put it really close, will I be able to put a third one? No, it doesn't look like it. Let's split the difference. See, but then it gets closer to this corner. No, I think I want them really close together and away from the corner. Like that. Yes. See? That's what I'm talking about. Let's go down and get our gruel. I queued up quite a bit of gruel down here in the fire. 150, that's probably good. We're not going to activate the second wheel yet, but now we have a second wheel for when we go out to get another thrall, because apparently these small wheels of pain, the lesser ones, take a ton of time. We've already been recording for over 30 minutes, and it still hasn't... And it's gone through quite a bit of gruel. Okay, that's fine. That's just fine. Now, ooh, look at these. Very cool, very cool. And then we could, well, there's already one there. All right, let's figure out, before I get all into that, we'll move this here. Let's figure out what we're going to do with this section, and then we're going to wrap up the episode. The wall doesn't really join with the foundation. Well, it's good enough. I could live with that because we could add wedge foundation there and that would seal up the light. Yeah, okay. I don't know if we want to add wedge foundation there, but I want to see what it looks like. And then we'll probably wrap things up. Let's see. Triangle foundation, not wedge. Triangle foundation and also square foundation and some walls. Yep. Some ceilings, of course. Some triangle ceilings, of course. All right. Let's go see what this looks like before we make any final decisions. Because what I'm thinking is that if I put this wedge here, see, it's going to let me put the wedge down there, and then I could... But you can't stack wedges. I'm pretty sure I've read that that is not a thing that you can do. So that would be where we want the foundation to be. And look at that. It does. It blocks in the light. So then what are we going to do with this section? This section is just going to have to be foundation. That's all there is to it. Okay. So let's do that. We'll do that right now. Won't take that long, and it'll give me a pretty good idea if I'm on the right track or not. Look at that. And then foundation there. Woo! Look at that! That's what I'm talking about! So we got, like, the mountain right into the wall, which is precisely what I wanted. Ooh, it'll even let me do that. Yes! See, that's exactly what I want, is, like, the building to be built around the mountain. I love it. I love it. And we can put, like, maybe a little chest back here or something silly. We can put some stuff in the corner. I think I'm going to put my other Stygian brazier over here in this corner, maybe? Or maybe by the steps? Maybe by the steps. We can make some more easily enough. I'm not going to sweat it too much. We will get some decorations and stuff for this place. Oh, snap. Who hears me? You? Are you kidding me? Well, I can see an archer's going to go in this area. So now, this hyena has helped us discover exactly where our archer is going to go, which is right here on this outcropping. Now, what the question is can I build wedges off of this? And then square that over there, which I think I can. Oh, I'm thirsty! I've never been so thirsty in my life! No, I have. There, look at this. So we have kind of this rounded... Oh, I could triangle point it, but I kind of don't want to. Are you kidding me? What are you attacking? Is attacking the mountain? Whatever. Whatever. I don't care. And then we could put some square foundations here. Like this. That's going to have to be more wedges, which is fine. All right. It's coming together, and then part of this is actually going to be open. The rest of the structure, I probably won't start until maybe here and leave it two open, or maybe three open. Maybe. Maybe. We'll see. It would be nice to have this rounded edge here. You know, I might actually... okay, so I'm thinking about it. I might off camera... actually tear up this whole section just to make this row, because you can't do it half square wedge and half triangle wedge and do this whole row in triangle wedges, triangle foundations. But then that has to be triangle foundation just to get a curve on this one corner. I'm trying to be okay with that corner. I think it's okay. Feel free to let me know in the comments what you think. I kind of wanted this first building to be square and the towers to be rounded. I kind of wanted the dichotomy of square buildings and round buildings. Anyways, but we are going to wrap it up before this episode is getting a little long. We're already at 40 minutes. You. Are you down there eating my stuff? All right, well, before we wrap up this episode, we're going to take care of this guy. Come on. Yeah. That's what I thought. Why don't you just hush your mouth, hyena? But that is going to be the end of it. So this has been Conan Exiles episode 31. Thank you so much for joining me. I hope you had a good time watching me build. As always, I had a good time playing. I can't wait to show you more next episode to see how this develops. I don't know if you guys want me to build more off camera and just bring you back when it's done, or if you actually like watching the building process. The way that I view it personally for me is that there's a lot to be learned just about how building pieces come together and how building pieces don't. And for me, this is the kind of thing I would want to watch. If I was coming up on somebody's video, I don't want to just see what they have built. I want to see what they went through to build it, the tricks they had to use to get the stairs to snap, the way the wedges and the squares work together, because there's not a lot of videos out there that show building step by step, at least not that I've seen. A lot of them are just, hey, look at my magnificent building. And I like to bring you guys the trials and tribulations that I go through to build it, so that hopefully if you're trying to build something similar, you can look at it and go, well, when I watched Thranxes do it, he had an issue like this and he fixed it like this. So hopefully I've been able to bring that to you. But again, feel free to let me know in the comments what you thought. Come back next time as we most likely continue to build. But until then, take care.